I'm Gail Locke McDowell, author of Cracking the Coding Interview. Today we're going to talk about bits. So we're going to talk about how positive and negative numbers are represented in binary. We're going to talk about operations like shifting and arithmetic, including the logical and the arithmetic shift. And then we're going to talk about how we can use masks to do operations like clearing, setting, and getting bits. Now, there's a little bit of cross-dependency in these topics, so the order might seem a little bit funny to be jumping back and forth, but it'll be a little better this way. So let's relate this to base 10 numbers. What does a number like 583 mean? What do those digits represent? Well, it's 5 times 10 to the second plus 8 times 10 to the first plus 3 times 10 to the zeroth. In base 2 or binary, we can do the exact same thing. Now let's talk about adding. Well, in base 10, we add up the two digits, and if it hits our limit, then we roll that over to the next digit. So we add the 3 and the 7, that gets 10. That hits our limit of 10, so we roll that 1 over. And now we're adding a 1, an 8, and a 3. And that gives us 12. So we get a 2 down here, that hits our limit of 10, so we roll that over up here. And then we're adding a 6, a 5, and a 1. And that again hits our limit of 10 per digit. So we wrote down that 2, and we carry the 1 over, and we get 1, 2, 2, 0. So we can do that exact same thing in binary. In binary, of course, our limit of each digit is just 2. So we're going to add this 1 and this 1, and that's going to hit our limit of 2. So we're going to record a 0 over here, carry the 1. Now we're going to add again a 1, a 0, and a 1. That's going to again hit our limit of 2. So we're going to record a 0 there, carry the 1 over. And now we're going to add a 1 and a 1. Again, we're hitting this limit of 2. So we're going to record a 0 here, and carry the 1 over, and we get 1000. So that's, again, how you do binary addition. It's very, very parallel to what you do in base 10. Now let's talk about how we represent negative numbers on a computer. Typically, a negative integer is stored in 2's complement form. And what this means is that the very first bit is used to represent the sign. A 0 means that it's a positive number, and 1 means it's negative. Then the remaining bits over here are filled in with the 2's complement, the number that you'd have to add to these, to the positive version, to the absolute value, to get 2 to the 8th in this case. We use 8 because it's an 8-bit number. So let's think about this. What number would we have to add to 0010010 to get 1000000? Well, if we just added the inverse of 0010010 to it, then we would get 0 with a whole bunch of 1s afterwards. Therefore, if we add 1 up here and a 1 down here, we should get the values we're looking for. So remember that our original question was, how do we represent negative 18 in binary? Well, we take the positive value of that, the 18, and we look at this binary representation, and then we say, what number can we add to that to get 1 followed by a whole bunch of zeros? Well, the number we add to it to get all ones is just invert all the numbers. So if we add 1 to both of those, then we have 1101110. So therefore, the 2's complement, the number that you'd add to this series of bits here, is in fact that number. So our negative representation is this right here. So that's how we represent negative 18 in binary. So just to make sure you understand that, let's look at one more example. So if we want to convert negative 123 to binary, we'd be looking for the thing that we add to 123's non-signed bits, so these bits over here, to get 2 to the 8th. So we'd take 123, convert it to binary, so we get that, then invert all of the bits, and then we add 1 to that, and that will give us our 2's complement version of negative 123. The next topic I want to talk about is shifting, specifically two types of shifting, logical shifting and arithmetic shifting. So let's consider some number in binary, like this. So if we want to left shift, then we just move everything over by 1 to the left, and if we want to right shift, we move everything over by 1 to the right. Now we've been talking about these in binary so much, we forgot what these numbers actually are in base 10. Interestingly, that top number is 23, and this left shift number is 46, and the right shift number is 11. Now, what do you notice about those numbers? Well, the left shift had the effect of multiplying that number by 2, and right shift had the effect of dividing it by 2, of course, with some truncation in there. And that's not a coincidence. That's what a left shift and a right shift generally do. Now, some of you might be wondering, what happens on a negative number to this sign bit if we're doing a right shift? Does it shift with the number or not? And that's an interesting question. And that's where we get into logical versus arithmetic right shifts. So let's consider the number negative 23. In a logical right shift, we do what we would logically think that a right shift would do. We move everything, including the sign bit, over. This gets us this weird value of 116, which doesn't really seem to have any particular relationship to the number negative 23. The arithmetic right shift operates slightly differently, but in doing so, preserves an arithmetic relationship between the original number and the new right shifted number. What the arithmetic right shift does is it shifts everything over by 1, including the sign bit, but then it fills in the sign bit with the original sign bit instead of what a 0, as in the logical right shift. The resulting number is negative 12, which does still bear that sort of that divide by 2 relationship, except that with negative 23 dividing by 2 is negative 11.5, so we're rounding to negative 12 this time. So now we're on to our final topic, using masks to do things like getting a bit, updating it, things like that. First, let's review some of the basics. When we AND 2 bits, we get a 1 only if both of those bits are 1. When we OR 2 bits, we get a 1 if either of those 2 bits are 1. And when we do an XOR, we need exactly one of those 2 bits to be a 1. If both are 1s, we get a 0. So now let's turn to how you'd get a particular bit in a number. So how would we figure out if, say, this bit was a 1 or a 0? Well, if we create a mask or just a number that has a 1 only in that one bit, and we AND it with the original number, that'll indicate whether that value is a 1 or a 0. Because if there's a 0 there, the whole number will be 0. Otherwise, it'll be something bigger than 0. So that mask can be created by taking 1 and shifting it over to the left by I spots. So to figure out if the ith spot is a 1 or a 0, we just compare x, do an AND of x with that mask, and say, does that not equal 0? Now, what about setting the ith bit? Well, we can do a very similar thing. We create actually the exact same mask, and we just OR it with that original value, and that'll make sure that that ith bit is set. Now, what about clearing the ith bit? Well, that's a little bit trickier, but still very doable. What we want to do is AND it with a mask that has a 1 everywhere else but that one spot. But how do we create such a mask? Well, all we have to do actually is just take our mask from before and invert it. And that's exactly what we see here. So we've now covered the basics of bit manipulation. We talked about how numbers are represented both in positive and negative form. And then we talked about different operations like how we add numbers, comparing that to base 10 numbers. We talked about shifting, both logical and arithmetic. And then we talked about how to do getting, setting, and clearing using masks. So from candidates, there's a lot of focus on learning different bit manipulation tricks and things like that. What I really encourage people to do is just really solidify their understanding of the basics. And from there, a lot of these tricks and things like that will follow. But really nail that foundation of the basics. So now that you've seen these basic operations, why don't you try your hand at a new bit manipulation problem? Good luck.